I'll respond to that, actually.
The county
has indicated that it does not have a plan to put a landfill site at Site 41. Mm-hmm. However, the C of A still exists.
Wow.
So we still exist.
We would like our time to be here worth something. Mm-hmm. Our time is valuable as well. And to go over this, thrashing it over and over and over, and it goes nowhere.
Ms. Woods, and there's no reason to have to be here. This is the choice of the committee to continue to have these meetings. Maybe Greg could update us on that.
Yeah, we haven't got an answer back on that.
It's an interesting comment, and thank you very much. You know, I got to look at the people here. This is our community. They're here for a purpose. They're not going to roll over and be tramped on. So much that's been discussed here tonight is totally redundant. I agree. The county council has said it will not be a landfill site. So maybe we can't believe them. I don't know. But this present council has said that. So I understand there's so much background going on here, and there's so much unanswered as to where we're headed. And all I can say, and Rob's going to say to me, it's not the mandate of this committee. I disagree with you, Rob. This is the mandate of this committee, that we keep the people informed. They know what's going on with the developments now. We're looking for a proposal of what may happen from Stantec. And don't say it's not related to this community monitoring committee or the people of this community, because I firmly believe it is a part of our mandate to keep them informed. And I'm not going to...
41 was closed down. We had an issue with a gravel extraction close to the site. I believe Mr. Jager made recommendations that this not happen. I believe there's some hundreds of acres involved in this. And I'm just wondering, directed at Greg, whether the MOE, who have allowed this to take place, are monitoring to see what's happening at Site 41 with the Alliston Aquifer, with the Upper Aquitard, with the Middle Aquitard, and all of the other that has been going on. Has there been any impact from that action, and will there be any in the future? Is the MOE monitoring this? Site 41 was going to impact these water sources. Is this adjacent situation going to make it even worse?
Sorry, just before you, Greg, just to clarify, because much of the information was completely erroneous. Essentially, Mr. Jager did not say that. Mr. Jager said, and it came before this committee, was asked whether there would be any concern or impact with the Site 41 upper gradients of the water taking up what happened there. His conclusion, when he looked at it, said there's potential it should be studied further, and that was what was sent off to the consultants. He did not say that it should not be built, that there should not be that. He asked for further study.
Why is that study?
I'm not the person who's taking care of that particular file. I know the one you're talking about. I know there's additional requirements done for study. If you want, I can get you a copy of the permit to take water.
Mr. Jager recommended and said it would be prudent to have the hill protected. However, he was not hired to do that, and the county didn't instruct him to do so. However, he felt it would be prudent to protect the entire hill. And that's in the tripartite meetings during the day I was there.
That I'm going to have a chance to have a look at it and see where that came from. What you said about my professionalism is concerning.
Thank you, Steve, for being more thorough than I am. I just know that the information was out there. The water taking permit, probably given by Mr. Kerr or somebody at MOE in London. Why then, with those kinds of professional background, which I'm sure the MOE was aware of because of the tripartite meetings, why then would they allow that water taking to take place?
I can't comment on events that I wasn't a party to, or what Mr. Jager went out to do. That's about as far as I can respond.
Yeah, so again, we have an MOE that isn't really doing due diligence in making sure that all aspects of our water is being protected.
Actually, the Ministry of Environment brought through a number of initiatives recently to save drinking water.
laughable.
Different people quite severely. If you sit on one of the source water protection committees, you know how they're functioning, and it's a kind of cradle and grave approach. So,
yeah,
if you're interested in that
cradle.
Information, I'll get that to you as well.
Well, the big problem is that some time ago, there were a number of us, seven of us, invited up to Mr. Garrettson's little room high on St. Clair Avenue. At the time, he said to me personally, and there were seven others or six others there, that there would be a follow-up meeting with him within 7 days of that meeting. I've heard absolutely nothing. Nobody from the LOE has contacted me.
The costs that we're hearing about, I'm so disappointed to see that Mr. Anson Cartwright had to spend over $300 to get the information. We have a committee here that is supposed to be provided with technical information and questions answered and give the feedback to the public. And I'm just appalled at the cost that is being charged. And while the county spends hundreds of thousands of dollars on a PR firm to try to boost their image, I think.
There was 22 of the records of invoices from the county's lawyers, Graham, Wilson, and Green, totaling $112,668 with details blanked out. Together with the invoice from Jagger Hens for the Modlow demonstration at the 2008 TRIPAT meetings, the total comes to $245,000. And this does not include the County Communications Department to fight the legitimate request of taxpayers to know how our hard-earned money is being spent.
And what I'd like to know is whether Mr. Douglas Jagger has been retained for any work by the county within the last 6 months, the last 180 days.
And need the answer, Mr. Chair. The answer is no. Mr. Jagger retired over a year.
Oh, he retired. How convenient.
Yeah. Mr. Chair, I am quite aware that Mr. Jagger retired and sold his company. My question was, has he personally been retained by the county or through Genevar for the county within the last 180 days?
Your question is Genevar been retained?
No. I'm personally not aware of that, but he works at he wrote the department absence. He's also a geotechnical engineer as well as a hydrogeological engineer. I'm not aware of him being hired.
The county of Simcoe have a bylaw. It's law. And if you read Steve's statements there of what you have to pay to get information, and you can't bypass that. So it is a law that's been imposed by the County of Simcoe. If you want that information, you pay. I'm not saying it's right, but that's the way it is. And I'm coming back to where I was before. There's a budget. Administrative staff stay within the budget. They can do what they want, and they're doing it. And I'm not saying it's right or wrong at this point. I'm not pointing fingers, but I think the best way to handle it all is to make sure you elect the right people this fall.
Yeah.
They can do what they want, and they're doing it. And I'm not saying it's right or wrong at this point. I'm not pointing fingers, but I think the best way to handle it all is to make sure you elect the right people this fall.
Yeah.